Well, I was joining a realm the other day, and you can see here, it says 0 out of 10. And this being a skyblock realm, you're never going to really have issues with mob cap. But that got me wondering, how many mobs are actually in mob cap? Because I consider mobs a really important part of Minecraft playing, and there is a global hard cap at 200 mobs, counted in some weird esoteric way where they just randomly decide if a mob counts in global cap or not. But the question I had was, how many players can actually play on a server before you don't get mobs like you normally would? So I went through a big data collection project, and let me show you how this worked. Then we're gonna go talk about what those statistics tell me. And you know, it's kind of interesting. I jumped into this world. This was a world that was created with a random seed. I've actually not looked at it. You pretty much have seen as much of the world as I've actually looked at. But what I've done is I made a behavior pack. In this behavior pack, I made this mobs tool. So around me right now, you can see these mobs are what count towards global mob cap. I have removed all of the entities I'm aware of that are in Minecraft that don't count towards mob cap. So like, for instance, iron golems do not count towards mob cap, but bees do. I don't know why that is, but through testing, I know that's true. And another thing, like villagers do not count towards mob cap, but cats do. So this is all stuff that I put together to try to help when you're on a server to determine where mob cap is filled. And I believe there's a moderations tool pack that I put out, but if not, I need to do an update to it anyway to make it work with commands. So I need to do an update on that at some point in the near future anyway. But for now, all I did was take the code from that pack and make a loop around it. So now if I run this test, it's going to teleport me to a random spot in the world. And you can see I teleported to 94,320 and minus 4,600 and then fell straight down to the ground. Now my player would stand here just AFK in creative and wait for 30 seconds. And then we would measure how many mobs are actually around me at this point in the world. And I did this for like 10 hours. And then I did it again on Sim 4, Sim 6, Sim 8, Sim 10, and Sim 12. So all in all, I have done about 4 days worth of teleporting around and measuring what mobs spawn where. So what I have learned is what's the maximum number of mobs, what's the distribution of mobs look like, all of that sort of stuff, and that's what this video is going to cover today. So if you're a stats nerd, buckle up, because I'm going to put all of this data in and you can mine through it however you want. It'll be broken out per mob. It'll give you the spot. I'll put the seed out, and I'm gonna put the pack out so people can modify it and measure whatever they want. But let's get into the meaningful stuff for you. Okay, this is Wiggly Lines, and what you have on the top is a probability distribution function and a cumulative distribution function. If you don't know what those are, I'm going to do some basic explanations of how to look at this data, so don't be afraid. Here you can see that there is different sims and some different tests. So I ran this a couple of different ways. One is I ran Sim 4 at just teleport them to the top of the world, and I ran it so I teleported at 60. One of the things I noticed when I teleported at 60 was sometimes I would be inside of a mountain and not actually get any mobs to spawn around me because that mountain was solid, which is sort of weird. But at spawning at the top of the world, I would always have surface. That did reduce the number of mobs I have in a cave cap, so really I probably should do this again at a lower terrain height so that I can get another curve, but you can kind of see when you're at 60, so slightly below ground, or you know, just doing a little bit of caving, you get a little bit more mobs than you do if you're on the surface. So These plots may be actually skewed depending on your use case. However, this shows you a good what is the most common number of mobs that you would have on the server. Now, a cumulative distribution function is used to tell you things like 96% of the time we have less than 50 mobs, or 75% of the time we have less than 39 mobs. So this can tell us what percentage of the time we have how many mobs or fewer. I am using these to tell me how the different sims compare. So Sim 4, if you didn't know, and I have a video on this, has a spawn radius of 44 and a despawn radius of 44. Sim 6, you see this massive jump in mobs around you. That's because there is a spawn radius and despawn radius of 128 and a despawn in the chunk right outside of Sim. So it works fundamentally different. Sim 8 just adds another couple of chunks. Sim 10 adds another couple of chunks, and Sim 12 adds a couple of different chunks. You'll notice these two lumps that are really strong in Sim 4. What this is when you are not in an ocean, and this is when you're in an ocean. You get a similar thing on Sim 6, and then they kind of just flatten out depending on if you're in an ocean or not on Sim 8, 10, 12. So this is actually just the impact of fish. Fish are one of the things that Minecraft should have changed global mob cap for. Putting 32 fish around the player and then leaving global mob cap at 200 is sort of crazy to me. So if you're in the ocean, you're actually taking up more than twice as much mob cap on a realm compared to your friends who are on land. And that's sort of, you know, scary. The other thing that's kind of scary is in my testing, I actually measured up to 195 mobs in mob cap. This graph is smoothed out, so that kind of rounds to zero, but I measured up to 195 mobs on Sim 12 in mob cap, which is just nuts that one player can take up 195 mobs. Now, this doesn't seem to be that useful on its own. Like, this just tells you how many mobs around a player, but I can use this to simulate if every player on the server has an independent base, meaning that they're further than sim distance apart. What's your mob cap going to look like for just a vanilla server? No lighting, no cave lighting, no spawn proofing, no collection of animals, no zoos or anything like that. Just playing Minecraft, adventuring, and seeing what happens. And that's my next plot I can take you to. Let's start off at Sim 4 at the surface. So again, this is cumulative distribution functions. This means when I put my cursor on the screen, I could tell you that there is, with 10 players on the server, a 92% chance that you would want to have 300 mobs. And there is a 20% chance, if you randomly distribute your bases, that you are not at mob cap, which sounds unplayable to me with 10 players, which brought me up to that realms have 10 player cap sort of figure. It doesn't feel right if mobs are important a part of Minecraft that you set the realm limit to 10. Yes, the CPU can probably handle 10 players around in a mixed fashion, but you cannot have 10 bases on the game. You cannot have 10 people in 10 different locations in that server, which seems to mean to me like 10 is too many for that particular use case. Even 9, 41% chance that you are at global mob cap if you are playing with 9 players in 9 different bases. I would argue that 6 or 7 is where we should start talking about it being playable. At 7 players, you have a 17% chance, or an 83% chance, that you're not at mob cap, 17% chance that you are at mob cap. At six mobs, you're at 5% chance that you're at mob cap, or 95% chance that the game is playing smoothly. And then at five players, you are at 99% chance that the world is playing smoothly, and only a 0.7% chance that you are actually at global mob cap. These numbers, very reasonable. So to me, yeah, you can actually play with multiple players on a server up to about 6 or 7, maybe 8, depending on what your preferences are. We're playing on a realm, but there is no way that you're playing at 10 or 11 without hitting mob cap. It's just not statistically likely with normal Minecraft worlds. So that also brought me to the question of, what about bigger sims? What about these big sims that they have built in? You can run BDS, you can run that on beefier hardware, you won't get lag. How many players can play on, let's say, Sim 6 before you start to hit mob cap? So on Sim 6, you can play one player for sure. You can play two players, absolutely fine, no mob cap issues. But as soon as you get the third player online in a different spot, there is a 50% chance that you are at mob cap. At four players, there is a 2% chance that you are not at mob cap. 98% of the time, you will be at mob cap. So for Sim 6, this 200 mob cap is unusable. It's honestly not even possible to play multiplayer Minecraft. If you're talking about Sim 6 and you want to play 10 players, that's the default number of players in the BDS server file. That is the default number of players on the Realms Plus. If you want to play 10 players, mob cap should be 800 on Sim 6. It's just, that's what it should be. Doesn't mean it'd be actually playable from like a Minecraft perspective, but if you're going to actually set the default to 10 players on Sim 6, you need 800 mob cap just to get there. I could hear an argument for 650 mobs in that global cap, but that's, you know, if you're willing to say 50% of the time being at mob cap is acceptable, I could hear an argument for that. Now, Sim 6 and Sim 8, if you remember when we go back to this plot, it is, you know, mobs are increasing. So let's see what it looks like at Sim 8. At Sim 8, mob cap should be 1,000 plus. It should be maybe up to 1,100, but it should be 1,000 or more just to get you that 50% chance of having mobs on the server. We'll do a quick look at Sim 10, and you know where this thread is going. It's going to be a lot of mobs. If we were playing with 10 players on a server at Sim 10, we would want 1,400 mobs in cap-ish, or around 1,200 mobs to get to 50% chance that you hit mob cap with 10 players online. And you guessed it, for Sim 12, it's 1,400 mobs. Now, how do we get this many mobs on the server with a global mob cap of 200? Like, how do we even, for two players, this is gonna feel like you're playing on Peaceful on Sim 12, just being honest. Like, you will never see a mob in your face on Sim 12 with two players. It is statistically unlikely you even see a mob. Three players, forget about it. Like, it's just not usable. So how did we get there? So on Sim 12, we need 1,400 mobs to get to 50% of the time not having mob cap, or 1,600 mobs to be 99.9. So like somewhere between 1,400 and 1,600 mobs is required for Sim 12. But you can see, like, for Sim 12, if you got two players online, you're probably never going to see a mob. If you got three players online, it is extremely unlikely that you will actually run into mobs when actually adventuring. And I wanted to talk a little bit about that. So how did we get here? And the answer to me is, there are two updates that really broke this. And the updates for those are the aquatic update and caves and cliffs. I'm going to jump back into the functions. So the aquatic update made this lump here, which is almost half of the time, it's about 30% of the world, is now at this extra 32 mobs. And you can see that trends pretty much up through all the sims. So you effectively doubled the number of mobs at Sim 4, and so on and so forth. The other thing that changed was in Caves and Cliffs, when they added 16 mobs to the cave cap versus the 8 that was originally there. That was approximately a 30% increase in mobs. So between those two updates, the number of mobs on server should have just statistically gone from 200 when it was playable in 2014, 2016. It should have gone up to 400 based upon those two changes. Statistically, I believe that is what is true. If we did that, then we would have no mob cap issue. If it would have been adjusted correctly for each of those changes in Caves and Cliffs and in Aquatic Update. That didn't happen because the mobs were just added, and I guess Mojang played in single player, which statistically doesn't see an issue right now with mob cap, but when you actually look at the numbers, it should have changed. It really should have. I know back in the time that Aquatic Update came out, persistent mobs were a problem, and the developers focused on fixing persistence and then also adding mob despawning and all that stuff that helped in 1.16. But for global cap, we're still statistically wrong. So that is what really needs to happen, is we need a higher global mob cap. And in order to get that, I don't know what Mojang has to do, but really, I do feel like it's misleading for them to sell realms playing on Sim 4 with 10 players, because you won't see the mobs that are coming in after a certain number of people are online, which is somewhere around 6 or 7. So if you learned something, let me know in the comments what you learned. Otherwise, I'm going to dump all of this data into a Git repo. You can comb through it. I'll put the behavior pack that I used for testing, the Python scripts I used for processing. All that will be open source and available for you. And yes, I did test with night on only because, yeah, these things do make a difference. And I'm assuming half the day is night. So if you are running these tests again at daylight, I would be curious to see what your results are. Anyway, this is Mad Hatter, and I'm out. Bye.